Well, you did very well. Sarah wasn't going to be very nice to you. She went after you.
Yeah, it's a little late now, isn't it? She said she's sorry, but hey, I want to thank all of you for the demonstration. Michael, go ahead and tell us where your school is at, and go ahead and tell us a little bit about the hours that you're open and so forth.
Okay, the school is in Mishawaka, Indiana, which is adjacent to South Bend. The address is 109 Lincoln Way West. Mm-hmm. It's open from about 4 in the afternoon till 9 in the evening. The phone number is 256-0111.
Okay, well, I wish all of you the best of luck with your competing in the future, and, you know, I hope everything goes well with your traveling girls. You're at a young age, God knows, but another 10 years, who knows where you'll be at, maybe the Olympics. Michael, the best to you, and my thanks to all of you for coming down and being on my show, and best of luck with everything. And that'll wrap up this edition of Interesting Individuals on Guard.
Yeah.
We're making our journey up the walkway, straightway. Deck. Okay, deck. Here on Schooner America. And Jesse, how long is the ship again?
The ship on deck is 105 feet, and it's 139 from the bowsprit to the very tip to the end of the stern.
And we're by one of the masts, and I know we're not going to be able to shoot way up there, but how tall are the masts?
The main mast, and to the top of the flagpole is 108 feet. We go up. When we have to go up and fix something, we put that halyard, this block right here. Uh-huh. You hook yourself into the bowman's chair and climb up the stay, which is to the top of the mast itself is 89 feet.
Okay.
Do what you have to do and then back down.
And how tall is it again? I'm sorry.
108 feet.
108 feet. Down there. All right. You don't have to climb up there, do you?
Yeah, we have to sometimes.
How far up do you have to go?
Depends on where the problem is.
What do you have, like a safety harness in there?
Like we hooked into that halyard and up, up, up.
Up you go.
Where the winch is.
Uh-huh.
This winch.
Right.
And you go up and you do what you gotta do and you come back down.
You come back down.
Slowly.
Slowly, and I'd be going up slowly too. These are like compartments right here.
This is a paint locker. All our varnish, as you can see, we have a lot of varnish. All our varnish, sandpaper, everything we need for upkeep of the bright work. And then below it's the doghouse and the galleys right down here. These are skylights to the galley.
Okay. What type of food do you guys cook?
All kinds. We got a professional chef aboard. She cooks everything. Beautiful. Roast beefs, hams, delicious. We eat very well.
Alrighty. We'll hopefully have dinner when we're done taping tonight.
This is a vent to the generator room.
Oh, I see.
All our electricity comes from this room, mm-hmm. Fuel pumps, air compressors, everything. When we hook up the shore power to the generator in the box, big diesel generator.
Okay. Do you have to do a lot of maintenance on the boat, or is it okay?
Yes, quite a lot.
Really?
Very hard.
What are some of the main things you have to upkeep the most?
We wash the boat, the deck, 4 or 5 times a week, the whole deck. All that. We have to keep up on all the varnish work. We have to fix the sail, make new lines, whatever's broken at the time.
I see. And then we're just going to keep on continuing here, and Mike's doing some work. He's wrapping up some rope of some type.
Room to the foremain, our second mast, all the way in the front.
Sure.
The foremain sail. This is the gaff. Gaff made out of carbon fiber. This is all the bright work on the boom and the mast, so Douglas fir from British Columbia.
And I just happened to notice there's like a canoe or a boat that, you know, help out.
Dinghy. We have the rubber dinghy off the boat right now. We put it right there. That one we don't use. We put storage. We put the radar up in it because our radar's ugly. Doesn't go with the boat. So we lay it down in there.
Whatever.
Storage, ladders, hose, ropes, everything.
What's in here, Jesse, this compartment?
This is down below in the cruise lawn. This is in one of the three hatches. You have the big one, this one, and there's one more up front.
I see.
Crew salon, like the pantry's there, the cook's cabin's here. We have some lines, mm-hmm. Storage, bowman's bag, coolers. It's just storage. All
right.
Foul weather gear. From the other crews the other night, everybody's getting seasick.
Oh, I see. Well, we don't want that.
People aboard.
And Mike is still getting further away from us. He's still doing his job, but he's... No, don't worry about it.
This is one of the winches to the jib sheet line. Mm-hmm. The jib will be up on the forward stay. Mm-hmm. Pull it over, and depending on which tack we're on, the line, this sheet line, will be on the winch, around.
Sure.
And into the self-tailer, and it holds. Instead of tying a knot. Very nice.
All right.
Winch it if needed. So, this is the stay. Goes up to the mast.
Right, and there's pulleys I see here that...
Yeah, these are dead eyes like on the original. Most boats you would see now, they just have just a knot you tighten, but we have to put it on that halyard and winch and winch and winch to tighten these.
I bet it is. They look big, they look heavy, and looks like it'd take a couple people to do that.
These are made out of carbon fiber as well, just like the insides of the mast and the gaffs. This is the running light. You can't see it from here. It's the port running light.
All righty.
That's a life raft.
Okay, in here, right here.
That's
I see.
Two life rafts.
That's two.
Two of them, all right.
Two more back there.
25 people in there and 25 people in those two.
How you doing, Kate?
I'm excellent. How are y'all? Just fine. We'll just put Kate on camera for a minute. You said there were other people. Hi, Kate. Where's Mom live?
Virginia.
Oh, another Virginian.
She'd like to catch a glimpse of me, Mike.
All righty. Well, Mike, what are you doing down here?
Well, I'm coiling one of the lines. I believe it looks like the Lazy Jack line, isn't it?
I see.
Lazy Jack line. Lazy Jack's holding up the boom and the sails down. See, one, two, three. Yeah.
Kate, do they do their job?
They're not bad. If they misbehave, I kick their butts.
You do.
Yes.
You do. All righty. Oh.
Here, listen to that.
I see. How many years have you been sailing?
3 years on this
boat. 3 years on this boat. All right, so you got into it a little bit later on, right?
Yeah, I'm a late bloomer.
Where are you from? You're from Virginia, right? You were saying?
Yeah.
Whereabouts in Virginia?
Manassas.
Manassas. Is it near any water?
Not really. We live on a river, but I have a lot of time in the water.
All righty. Good enough. And gentlemen, we're at the second mast here.
The first mast.
The first mast. Foremast. All righty. We're making our way towards the end, and please tell me about way out there. Any of you have to crawl out there every now and then to do your job?
Walk straight out. Walk straight out on it.
Uh-huh.
I can do it if you want it on camera.
I don't know. Do we want him to do it, Dan? Go ahead. Camera guy says go ahead and do it. No, I think... Why don't one of you explain what he's doing, because we can't hear from that far out.
Well, when we take the sails down, we have to have someone out there to make sure the hanks go down in order, and then two people are in the net to pull the sails in so they don't fall into the water. If there's any wind at all, it blows us around. It's a lot of work getting the sails up and down, and it requires all the crew members, male and female.
Outstanding. We enjoyed that. We enjoyed seeing that. Sure, you had to have some balance and so forth. So. Well, gang, this is excellent. I appreciate the tour. It seems like a lot of you all know your jobs. A lot of work, like you said,
we're
some strange work.
Synchronized, just like a band.
With you on here, I have a feeling it's no other way but a team.
Or the highway.
Your way or the highway. Although there's going to be...
Just bossy.
Oh, all right. Well, see. Everybody enjoys... what do you... what is the most pleasure that all of you get out of being out on the water so frequently like this sailing?
Everything.
Just the beauty.
The quiet.
Yeah, the peace of it.
Not the real world. It's just another world. All you see is fish and turtles and whales and shooting stars and full moons. And we like the salt water because it's longer trips. But we like your lakes, too, because everybody's so nice and they're nice places and short trips. And we can take people with us, which we do as often as we can. The more the merrier. That's this boat.
Gentlemen, anything you want to add? You just pretty much agree with Kate, don't you?
They better.
Yeah.
We have to.
Okay, guys, thank you.
Fear. We live in fear.
Oh, boy. Hanging up there like in the old Pirates movie.
They trust me.
All righty. Everybody, thank you so much. Thank you. Great.